Hello guys, and welcome to another Applied Energy 6.2 tutorial. In this video, I will only talk about automatic crystal growing or auto-crafting pure crystals and how to do that with only Applied Energy 6.2 items and blocks. There are ways to do this with other mods, and those ways are better at this point. And because this setup has a few flaws and limitations, but that's not the point. The point of this is to do it with 100% AE2 items and blocks, well, and vanilla stuff, so you're not dependent on other mods to do it. And this is the best solution I have so far, so if you have any ideas of how to improve it, then I encourage you to provide me with those solutions so I can improve this. But let me get started and I will go through everything. In this first setup, I will do the easy part, the Fluix crystal process. That's combining redstone nether quartz and shard surface quartz. So what we have here is a vanilla hopper sorter. It's an automatic filtering system, I guess you can say, and it will only accept items that you specify. So in this setup, I will only accept Fluix crystals to go into this process. The water is, perhaps you can have it in a better way. I just think it works. In my testing, this works best. So if I throw a few items here, they will just stay on the hopper and nothing will happen because they can't go into the hopper because we can only accept bricks and the Fluix crystal. But if I throw in a few of those, then you can see that they end up in this hopper and then are sent down here. I can show you again. 1, 2, 3, 4. They go in and they are sent down here. But it stops here because we have 22 items, and 22 items in a hopper, and you place a comparator next to it, it will output a power of 1. One more item in it, that means it will output a power of 2 signal. That means we can travel the signal down here, activate the redstone repeater, and that will disable the torch, and that will let the one item pass through, and then it will shut down again. So I can demonstrate that by throwing almost a stack. So now we have a power of 4, and that means that we will get items down here, it will be activated, and as soon as we, let's see, we have power of 3, power of 2, and at the power of 1 it will stop anytime soon. There we have it, and that means we should be back to normal. 22 items in here. Okay, so that's good. Now we can actually, and to import this into the system, we will need an import bus. Yes, here it is. Just like so. That means that the result will end up back here. And to craft this, we will need to order, I already prepared it, 1 redstone, 1 nether quartz, 1 shard surface quartz. That means that we will get 2 Fluix crystals. So let's get that pattern and get started. To drop the items, we will use, let's see, we'll have a sub network here. And we will use the formation plane. The formation plane will output or place whatever you put into the network, anything. And that means that we should have this as a subnetwork. So we'll use the interface here and here. I guess you've seen this before. So we place the pattern, let's see, where is it here? The pattern to craft, to create the crystal, goes into this interface, and thus it will output the items, the 3 items, into the orange network, and it will just be dropped down in the water and be sent to the water block over here, and that will transform them. And then we just need some power here, and now we're set. Now we can do Fluix Crystal, craft me one of those, if that means it will craft two. You see they ended up in here, they are sent along the line and they are down to the hopper, and we will the import bus. We have two, just like we wanted. Let's try a few more, eight perhaps. Start, all the items are just pushed down here. Hopper, hopper, and then they are imported into the network. And crafting one and zero. So now that works. That's the Flux Crystal process. It's a quite big contraption, mostly due to the hopper. If I could use the annihilation plane, it will be much easier because it will import or suck in or break anything you place in front of it or above it. The problem is that I can't filter it. The only thing I can think of right now is to have a timer. So we'll send, it will be deactivated as a standard, as the normal state. And we put items in the water block and then we wait for some time. I don't know, 30 seconds, 10 seconds, it depends on, you can see they're quite bouncy on the hopper, so you can't really rely on it. And after 10 or 30 seconds, we can activate the annihilation plane to suck the items in. But that then will do it regardless of if it's finished or not. But that's not a problem. That's the only problem, basically. So if you have a solution to that, feel free to provide it. I will start to build on the next setup that will craft the pure Fluix Crystal. And with that, I will use the accelerators. So this will be a quite big contraption, but we'll use the same principle as in the last one. So just let me get started. Okay, so I have started. So down here, everything is as it was before. We have items in here, and we should have a pure Fluix Crystal in here. And it will be sent down here, and that stone shouldn't be there. And we should have an import bus down here to the green network. I will use another color to keep them apart. So let's see, we can do remove those two, and yeah, the red one will be the, let's see, interface, the item dropper or what to call it. So two interfaces, just as we had before, and like so. And then we'll use the same setup as we had. I might change this depending on how it looks or how tight it will become. Okay, something like that. So we have this part, and then we need the pattern. And I know what, so we have one seed to one pure, right? Encode that. And we insert that pattern. Here it is. Okay, so this means that we can insert one seed in here. We have water, we have one block here and one block here. These facades, they will keep the water in place and hopefully the seed as well. This formation plane will just dump the seed in, and it has power. Now, you might be thinking, how will we power these accelerators? Because we shouldn't have them running all the time. We should have them running only when we have an item in here. And I know with some other mods, for example, Steve's Factory Manager, you can detect if an item is above that block. We can't do that now. But what we can do is that we can use the level emitter. And I will show you exactly how to do this. Perhaps here. Then we have the level emitter and we need the crafting upgrade. And we set it to emit redstone to while item is crafting. And then if we just set the pure fluix crystal in here, then it means that if we are crafting, in the process of crafting a pure crystal, output a redstone signal. And we will, let's see here. We don't want to connect it. So perhaps we'll do this. And like so, and then we have the toggle bus. Let's see if this works. Like that. So that means that if we are crafting, output a redstone signal here, this toggle bus will accept power and only power. It shouldn't matter, actually, we should be able to have it green, but I just want to keep them separated so we know exactly what we are doing. And let's see, we should have water here and water there that flows over here. Okay. Let's see if I forgot anything. Let's try it. Okay. Didn't I place pattern and crafting? Okay. Craft one. Oh, we need a CPU. Sorry. Let's place it anywhere. Craft a pure crystal and start. That means it should output a seed over here. It should flow. Yeah, you can see it down there. The accelerators are online. I guess you can fit one more accelerator here. Yeah, it should be easy, but it can be good to see what's happening. And as soon as it's done, as it reached the pure form, it will just jump down into this hopper and then be sent out through the import bus. So I'll be right back as we are closing in on that stage. Okay, let's see. We are very close now. It will be almost instant. So, and it will be nice to catch it. Oh, there it is. Just jumped down and it was so quick. So, and you can see the crafting is done. The emitter is not emitting anymore. So these are offline. And we have the crystal here. And we can order more as well. No, craft. 10, start. That means dropping 10 seeds. And all of them will just be here. There you can see the bouncy part. Hard to say if that's a real glitch or if it's just a graphical thing. I'm afraid it can be quite real because at some points they are just not in the correct spot. So, but basically that concludes this tutorial. If you have any suggestions or improvements, please let me know and I will also continue my investigations to see if we can improve this even further without involving other mods. So thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one. Take care. Bye-bye.